Good.
Ramadan Kareem, everyone. We're here to give you a pranayama sequence that you're supposed to do at the hottest time of the day that helps manage your water levels in your internal organs and keeps them healthy while fasting. Important aspect of this pranayama is this mudra here called Varuna or Jal Mudra. And you're going to hold this mudra for most of the time that we are doing the pranayama. So the first pranayama that we're going to do is the belly breathing. So you're going to take your block and put it on your belly once you're on the ground. So first you lie down, put the block on your belly, hold Varuna Mudra. When you inhale, the block should rise up. And when you exhale, the block should drop down. So we can zoom on the block. Inhale, 2, 3, 4. Exhale, 2, 3, 4. Inhale, 2, 3, 4. Exhale, 2, 3, 4. So just keep a steady breath rhythm as you inhale, the block rises up. And if you want, you can hold here for a count of 4. And then exhale, the block falls down for a count of 4. And it looks like this. Inhale, 2, 3, 4. Hold, 2, 3, 4. Exhale, 2, 3, 4. Hold, 2, 3, 4. While you're doing this, you're going to keep your eye gaze in the middle of your brain. Tongue on the roof of mouth. Feel your spine. Imagine the breath is dropping down your spine as you inhale and back out the top of your head as you exhale. And we'll stay in this kind of breathing practice for 5 minutes. After 5 minutes, we come up and we go into an important position if you're fasting, and this is called Vajrasana. Okay, so Vajrasana takes the blood and keeps it in this part of the body, away from the legs. If you can't sit on your heels, then you can put the block underneath you, like this. Okay? While in Vajrasana, we're going to do another breath, and it's important also when you're fasting, and it's called Chandra Bedana, or left nostril breathing, or moon breathing. So you will take your left hand and you're going to keep it in Varuna Mudra. Your right hand will hold your nose with your thumb and third finger. The other two fingers are here. And you're going to open your left nostril and breathe in through your left nostril. And then hold your breath for a moment and breathe out through the right nostril. So inhale from the left, exhaling from the right, only from left to right. So don't go the other way, only left to right. It looks like this. Inhale, 2, 3, 4. Hold, 2, 3, 4. Exhale, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. And again, inhale, 2, 3, 4. Hold, 2, 3, 4. Exhale, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Again for 5 minutes. And then after 5 minutes, you're just gonna sit for a while. Do some more spinal breaths again. Taking the breath down your spine as you inhale and up your spine as you exhale. After that, we're going to go into child's pose. So child's pose helps massage your kidneys and colon. It's this position here. And you're going to breathe into your kidneys. So in this position, you're expanding your breath into the kidney area. 4 count inhale. And hold again for 4. 4 count exhale. And hold again for 4. Try to remain calm as you're doing this. quite pleasant. We're trying to cool the body down, cool the nervous system down, keep your nerves from getting cranky. Sometimes when you get hungry, your nerves kind of start to go on edge, so this will help to calm you down. Now, after that, we've got one last breath to do. Once again, sitting in Vajrasana, or if you're tired, just sit cross-legged. It's called the cooling breath. So once again, we are in Varuna Mudra. You're going to breathe out through your teeth like this. Inhale. Hold your breath and roll your eyes up into the center of your brain. Hold, count to 10. And exhale very slowly through the nose. So it looks like this. And you're going to do that around 10 times. Okay, 10 times, cooling breath. If your teeth don't feel good doing that, you can make a U with your thumb. So you're turning your tongue into a U shape. I can't do it. Or connect your thumb to your front lower teeth and then breathe in through your tongue like this. And same steps, count to 10 and after, exhaling. So let's try that. Inhaling deeply. Hold your breath, gaze upwards into your brain. Count to 10 and as you exhale, relax. And so after you're done with that, then you can lie down again and have a relaxation. Especially at this time of the day, it's important to lie down because this is what cools the body's fire. So lying flat on the floor like this, it's called Shavasana, and it actually does help. Try not to fall asleep. All right, so please practice this in between 1 o'clock and 3 o'clock in the afternoon when the sun is at its highest point. This will help you cope with the heat and the lack of food and drink. So I hope that this helps you in some way. Ramadan Kareem and Namaste.